Morning, ladies and gentlemen. It's Cliff here for YC Test Drive. I'm back again on my favorite spot. The reason I came in the mountains today, it's a different reason. I'll show you just now. But anyway, let me just brief you, tell you what's happening here. The temperature is just around about 13 degrees. It's getting a little bit chilly. Of course, we are moving slowly in winter, so which we love to see. The reason I'm here today, it's because of this. It's because of this. This, guys, this, ladies and gentlemen, this is a Kia Rio 2014 model.
So the 1.4 Kia Rio comes in a hatchback and a sedan. So this is a hatchback, a four-cylinder straight line, 1.4-liter direct injection petrol. That's about 8 kilowatts, about 135 newton meter of torque. It has some auto lights, which I love.
See the 360? As we go around it, we see the front grille, this black tiger front grille. You look at the fog lights, and we look at the lights, really lovely lights. Then we come to on the mirrors. You can see it has indicators on the mirrors, which is lovely thing for me, the indicators on the mirror. I love that. I love this little boot spoiler. This little boot spoiler, I'm not sure if you can see it. This little boot spoiler, I love it, with the brake lights there. You can also heat up the rear screen.
The Rio comes with a 15-inch standard rim. It's in competition with a few hatchbacks, such as Ford Fiesta, VW Polo, Renault Clio, Mazda 2, Opel Corsa, Toyota Yaris, Honda Fit, Hyundai Accent.
Looking at the windows, it has the, here are your, you have your auto windows, the back windows are also electric, and you have the central lock system on the side, and you can also lock the windows at the back so that the kids at the back should not be playing with the windows. Your mirrors, then you adjust them from here. You can also adjust your lights up and down. Here you can also dim your lights. You can see it's really quite nice. It's quite solid. It has some buttons on it that you can operate, which is really nice compared to the Polo that I did a review last week. This is quite it's quite fancy, actually. Looking at the here on the other side, you have then where you can answer your calls, where you can hang up your calls, you can increase your volume, and here that's where you then have the buttons for the mode on the other side. On this side you can also skip this. One of the things I like about this car is that when you come in and you put in the key and you switch on the key, it says Kia welcome, it greets you. I like this, the display, that you can also operate it from right here from the steering wheel. You can see a few things that you can operate from there. You can check, of course, that the distance before you run out of fuel. You can also check the fuel economy, and like now, as I was coming, I was doing 6.7 liters per 100 kilometers. That is the average. It shows you the outside temperature. And then if you press there, it shows you the fuel efficiency. Normally I will show you that when I, as I'm driving, it shows you the exact amount of fuel that you are, that is, that the car is using as you are applying your foot on the paddle. I'll show you how that one works. And also if you press again, it takes you, I like the way it is. The indicator, of course, the Asian cars, the indicator is different from the German. The indicator is on this side. This is where your indicator is, and then your wipers will be on this side. So look at the chrome, the way how they put this chrome trim around around all these gauges, all this chrome. It looks really quite expensive. It looks really nice, and I like the way they are set up separately. There's three of them. On this side you have then the fuel gauge and the temperature. On here, that's where you will have then your readings on your speedometer, and you have also a display of the fuel consumption, the outside temperature, which is 13 degrees as you can see, and also the fuel efficiency. And also on the other side, that's when then you have your rev counter, and then the other displays that would come when you switch on the car. Okay, that's really quite fancy. I love it. The dashboard also, it really looks quite expensive. You can see the chrome right there, the chrome on the volume on this, on the skip, and on the volume on the tuning. All these chrome as you come down here, it really looks nice and expensive. But then the price itself is not that expensive. Looking at the radio, it just flows well. You look at these buttons here, the aircon buttons. I like the way these aircon buttons are. It's really quite, it's just nice, it's unique. If we look at here, we have the 12 volt, charging, if you want to charge your phone, you have the aux cable here, you have the USB port here, and then you have your cigarette lighter here. You have a compartment here where you can keep some of your stuff here as well. Okay, when you come up here, you look at your aircon here, your rear screen, you can actually warm the rear window, just in case if it's getting foggy and you are driving, you can just warm it by pressing the button. Then you have that button of air circulation, and then if you want to allow air from the outside. This radio has Bluetooth that you can then connect and synchronize. You can then pick it up from the buttons of the steering wheels, as we were saying earlier. That's where you will then pick up. So the radio has Bluetooth. You can also play MP3 there. Few people nowadays play CDs, but anyway, you can play MP3 there. You have your radio, you have the media, you have your cell phone, and then you have your scanning, you have your setup of the clock, and then you have the menu. So the radio is fairly simple, not so complicated. That's quite easy. You have another compartment there, and also in here you have this really large compartment where you can, where you will have your service book, and you can also load other stuff inside there. So that's really nice. I love that compartment. It's quite big enough. And then your handbrake is right here, and you have your two cup holder, and here it comes with that ashtray and your two cup holders there. That's fair enough. So you have really quite a few compartments that you can also have on this side. And then you have this light, which is illuminating here. This light is actually, it's as soon as you switch on the car, this light will come on just to illuminate here on the cup holders and the rest of this other part on the bottom. So that's what this light is here for. It's a 6-speed manual. So with the reverse, there's a knob here on this side in front. You pull it in, push it this way, and then you push it that way. That's all for your reverse gear. But the other gears are quite normal. Gear 1, 2, 3, 4, and then 5, and then you have your gear 6. Okay, I just love that. I just love the fact. I think that's one of the things that gives it good in terms of fuel consumption. It's because the fact that it has gear 6, and also on the rev counter there, you will see that it has rev counters all the way up to 8,000 rev per minute. So that's good. That's very good. At the back here, you have really nice space. It can be a little bit tighter for someone who is taller, but I like it. There's still enough leg room, there's enough head space as well. And also for someone sitting on the middle, you can actually sit quite nicely here as well, on the middle. It doesn't have much of an issue with the space here in the middle. So someone sitting in at the back here, you really can't complain that much. There's enough space at the back as well. So I still really, really love it. It's a lovely car at the back. Okay, looking at the loading space at the back here, I like the boot. It has a soft button that you just press here, and then it pops up the boot. So I like that soft button. Okay, so at the back here, you should have enough loading space for two big suitcases, and then underneath there's a spare tire, which is the original spare tire. It's not this small thin spare tire, it's a really original mag rim spare tire. And then you have also a light at the back here as well. One of the thing I like about this car is that when you put in the key to try to start the car, it comes Kia welcome and all that. It writes that, it tells you to align the steering wheel. Other than that, it won't allow you to start the car unless you step on the clutch. So that in itself, I love that. Eventually I started the car, and then off I was on my test drive. That was lovely. Well, as we really, it just picks up. It's a 6-speed, so which makes it really quite full economical, as we say. So let's see how it will do on the Gorilla Elbow as we are coming up here, coming up on the curve here on the Gorilla Elbow. Let's see how it handles. It drives smooth, of course. I love the smoothness of it. Let's see how it handles, how it takes on the Gorilla Elbow. Whoa! Wow! It really did well with the Gorilla Elbow. As we are coming up by the monkey shoulder, let's see how it will handle with the monkey shoulder. It's quite smooth. It sails. It just goes. And it goes. It sails. The smoothness of this car is exactly what I'm talking about. Okay, we are coming up by the monkey shoulder. Here, the monkey shoulder, the heel, because normally this little heel throws you up. The monkey shoulder, there we go. It did well with the monkey shoulder. That's good. That's very good. That's impressive. It advises you to change gears. For example, it tells me to change to gear 2. I go up to gear 2. It tells me to change to gear 3. Actually, it's telling me to go to gear 4 already. I go to gear 3. Tells me already to go to gear 5. Actually, I'm too slow for it. I go to gear 4. It tells me I'm not going to gear 5. It actually wants me to already be in gear 6. That's the full efficiency. That's the full economy. I like that. If you put it in gear, there it is, in gear 6. So I like the fact that it tells you when to change. It advises you when it feels it needs to be changed. So I just really, really like that. I like the fact that it does not have much of noise compared to the Polo that I was driving last time. You can hear that they really soundproofed it. The noise outside, it's quiet inside. I like the fact that the mirrors are quite wide. They have indicators on the sides, which is very good for nowadays, because then people can see that you are indicating from the mirrors already. I like that. I like the headroom in here. There's enough headroom. I like the steering wheel buttons. The upgrade, of course, it will have the parking sensors. It will have a few things, the reverse camera, the LCD radio. But this one is still quite nice. If I was to talk about a few things that perhaps I would say about this car, it would be the fact that it pulls in front. I still have an issue with cars that pulls in front, but this car, I like it. Even if it pulls in front, I like it because it's quite small. Weight to power ratio, it's around about 15 kg per kilowatt. One of the other things that I might not like about this car is the space. This space here, this space that you see here on the screen, it's quite really tiny. In between, you have to really check, but it's okay if you check in the mirror. In most of these hatchbacks, the small hatchbacks, they do not put speakers at the back doors. I don't know why. I think people sitting at the back would be complaining. And the automatic one will have a gearbox where, whenever you stop by the traffic lights, it will switch off the engine to try to save fuel. But with the manual, it doesn't have that option. It's good for fuel saving. Let's see how it picks up from 0 to 100. Come, Rio! Oh, nice. It just picks up and it goes. It just goes and it feels so smooth. It feels quite solid on the road. It feels quite solid as I'm in gear 5 now. It has full efficiency on it and the power. The fact that it's a direct injection. It's a 4-cylinder, straight line, direct injection. That is very good for fuel consumption. It gives it good power and also very good on fuel consumption. This car would cost you roughly around about 130,000 to 140,000. Of course, it's an older model. It's a 2014 model, 1.4 as we said earlier. This car is much cheaper, and for the features that it has inside, the specs that it has inside, I think you would score more on this car because of course it doesn't have cruise control. I love cruise control. I don't like cars without cruise control, but I think I can live with it on this one. This I can be exceptional when it comes on this car. It's impressive. It is so impressive. Just as it welcomes you when you put in the key and you switch on the car, also when you switch off the car and take out the key, it says goodbye. Just to tell you goodbye. What a lovely car. What a lovely car this to be. So friendly. It's clean. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, every good thing has an end.
So unfortunately, I'm now coming to the end of this test drive. I really enjoyed it. I'm now heading back to the city. I'm going to, of course, do some self-quarantine and keep safe, stay safe, always wash your hands, and stay at home.